Hey, I'm Rob, and this is another results painting tutorial. Hey guys, I want to welcome you back today as we paint Gandalf the White from Lord of the Rings Strategy Battle Game. After priming our miniature in black and overcoating with gray on top, we'll start on the skin using some beige red. And as always, remember to thin your paints down using water and take your time. After we're done with that, we'll come in with some Citadel Flesh Shade. As always with shades, do your best to allow them not to pull up. If they do, just dry off your brush and come in and soak it back up. We're gonna go ahead and get all the skin here, the face and the hands. When that dries, we'll come back with some beige red as our first highlight. After we're done with that, we'll come back with some basic skin tone and add it to our beige red. We're going to add it in various stages here, working on the forehead, the cheeks, and the nose, fingers, knuckles. And you just want to add the basic skin tone to the beige red in various stages until you're at a point where you're happy with it. If you go too high, don't worry, just come back with some beige red and start all over again. now we'll start on the hair using some white gray. I feel like this is a great solution for people with gray hair, gray beards, as it is not completely white and not too dark. It just gives you that right tint. And when adding Nuln Oil to it, it really comes out, I feel like it comes out really great. We go with our Nuln Oil, thin that with some water. This is going to add some depth to our hair. We're also gonna do it on our beard. And remember not to go too heavy here, we just need a little bit to do the job right. After we let that Nuln Oil dry for a little while, we'll come back with our original white gray, cleaning up the beard, the mustache, and the hair. Remember, don't go too heavy here. We don't want to cover up the Nuln Oil we just put down for shadowing and depth. Just a little bit here and there will make it look great. And now we'll start on the undergarments using some Screaming Skull. This is the area around the arms and underneath the cloak. And I know what you're thinking, hey, Gandalf is wearing white. Don't worry, we'll get there. We're gonna start out with Screaming Skull. We'll be right back. then after we're done with that, we're going to come in and add some Akrax Earthshade. When doing brighter colors, whites, yellows, things of those natures, I prefer to use Akrax Earthshade over Nolan Oil. I feel it gives better depth and character to the clothing than the Nolan Oil would, because sometimes it comes out really dark. And also, our guys are running around the forest and stuff, so their clothing is going to be a little dirty here. Remember to get decent coverage. Don't let it pull. If it does, just come in and clean it up. And after that, Akrax Earthshade is dried, we'll come back with the original Screaming Skull and start picking out some of the higher areas. Try and leave some of the recesses in there showing, because that's going to add some depth to our clothing. And just take your time. Here we are adding some white primer to our Screaming Skull. I decided to use white primer here because I felt it would help give better coverage than some of the other whites might. But overall, I was really happy with the way it came out. I mean, you can use any kind of white color you want. I just chose to use the Vallejo game color white. We'll be right back. are starting on the Kate the Outer Comet, and we're going to use some bone white this time instead of Screaming Skull. I wanted these two pieces of garment to look different. I don't want them to be the exact same color. And this one, I think, is going to come out just a little bit brighter than the undergarment, which in the movies, I believe his cape was brighter than his clothing underneath it. Remember to use the appropriate size brush here. Don't be using small brushes to do big jobs with. Then your paint's down. This is going to take several coats, so take your time. Don't get in a rush. Don't try and paint areas that are still wet. All you'll do is just pull the paint away and create a gigantic mess here. Again, we'll be using Agrix Earthshade, doing our best not to spill onto the other articles of clothing or letting the shade pull up in any of the flatter areas. Start bringing the color back up with the original bone white, hitting the higher areas, leaving the recesses in shadow. Go adding some white to the bone white. We're going to start working on bringing up that cape in various stages. We don't want to do it all at once. Also, remember to leave some of that bone white in the recessed areas. Take your time, do this in various stages. We'll be right back. have we're done working on the cape, we can use the same bone white mixture to start working on the staff. Be careful around the hands. If you happen to spill over, don't worry, just clean your paintbrush off, get the area wet, clean it up, and go back to work on the staff again. This time we'll be using some Nuln oil on the top of the staff to add some depth. Remember, we only want to do the top in the cutout areas, not the whole thing. After the Nuln oil dries, we'll come back with the bone white and try to clean up the head of the staff. And after we're done with that, we'll come back with some straight ivory onto the top of the staff and the sides. We're not going to do the bottom here, just the top and the sides. And this is going to be our only highlight to the staff. After that's complete, we'll start working on the sword, and we'll come in with some straight Vallejo Model Air steel. Don't forget to get that piece of the sheath underneath his cape, down by his feet. There's a little bitty piece of metal that's sticking out there. And now we'll add some straight Nuln oil to the sword. And after letting that dry for a while, I'm going to come back with some Vallejo Model Air steel to clean it up and then some Vallejo Model Air Silver for the highlights. Now we're going to come back with some light gray and hit his belt area. After the belt area is dry, use some thin down known oil for shading and re-highlight with light gray as needed. Finished product, Gandalf the White from Lord of the Rings Strategy Battle Game. If you like this video and would like to see more, remember to like, subscribe, and share to help my channel grow. Feel free to leave a comment below. As always, just one rule, make it great.